Alright guys, so with all of the 250 million download celebration festivities going on, I never actually got around to having a chance to awakening our boy, Shugesh, one of the original Dokkan memes. Of good luck is what Shugesh means. He's great. He finally got a Dokkan Awakening, and he's not really a bad card. I do think, really, of a lot of the great apes, Shugesh now probably falls into one of the more useful great apes, believe it or not. There are definitely a few better ones, of course, like Tora, but Shugesh is not bad. Like, I would say with his awakening, he's definitely a usable unit. Like, if you want to run him on the Giant category team or the pure Saiyan team, I do think he does. Like, he's fitting of a roster spot, really, on either of those teams. So let's go ahead and awaken him. Also, to explain the meme behind Shugesh, I actually did hear the story from Zenrot before, where this meme popped up of Shugesh, you know, the god of luck and blessing people and stuff, is originally one of the very first banners with really good cards was a AGL Super Saiyan 2 Goku and STR Super Saiyan Bardock banner. Those two units here, let me quickly show them. Those two units have since gotten Dokkan Awakenings. Where are either of them? Here's the Bardock. This is that original Bardock. And then the Super Saiyan 2 Goku is right here as well. On their banner, I believe that was when all of the original, like, rare, like, Team Bardock cards were also released. So, many times when people would do multi-summons and pull either the AGL Super Saiyan 2 Goku or the SCR Super Saiyan Bardock, Shugesh would almost assuredly be in, like, everyone's multi. So that's where it became kind of a meme of good luck. That's where the story does originate. So let me go ahead and level Shugesh up, and we will hop into an event. All right, guys. So we'll go ahead and hop into an event with this squad right here. Nearly a full rainbow team now that I get a good look at it. Now, the reason I designed the team sort of the way I did with the Great Ape Shugesh, the Great Ape Super Saiyan 3 GT Kid Goku, as well as the Great Ape Turles, is because that will allow us to get the maximum boost from Shugesh's passive. A lot of the Great Ape cards that just got Awakenings, Tora, Borgos, Shugesh, they get added sort of buffs from their passives based on if there are Great Ape units actually on your team, right? So I made sure that we could get the full passive buff from Shugesh's skill, but I didn't really want to show him off on the Giant category team, because while it is nice that they did finally give Giant units, you know, the ability to crit and get additionals and stuff from the dupe system, it really is just still a category that pales in comparison to virtually every other category, just because even still the units just aren't, like, really that good. Like, there's no unit on the level of Evolution Blue Vegeta or Ultra Instinct Goku over on the Giant category team. You know, maybe if they released, you know, some sort of LR Giant unit, then we could start talking. But as of right now, there is no LR on the Giant category team. Which is funny, I do feel as though, like, an LR transforming Piccolo from the end of Dragon Ball could be cool. I think an LR Kid Gohan from the Saiyan Saga could be fitting. You know, just as a couple examples. Even an LR Kid Goku, like from the start of original Dragon Ball, as a Great Ape could be an interesting card idea. Really as like another secondary Giant category leader. Well, actually, if they did another Giant category leader, that would actually be the fourth unit, actually, that would have a Giant category leader skill. Because we already have AGL Tapion. We have Physical Lord Slug, who's not too far off on Global, who is a pretty good unit. And then, of course, we also have the free-to-play Great Ape Bardock, who also gives a Giant leader skill category buff. All right, so here's our boy Shugesh. Oh, boy. Of course. We got Shugesh right there, and we're up against a physical-type unit. I don't want Shugesh to get pounded away, like, immediately, because he is only, you know, 1% in the dupe system. I haven't really given him significant dupe system buffs or anything like that. I will be curious to see how Turles is going to be able to handle any pressure from Bardock. Yeah, 54. 200,000 attack stat is fine because Shugesh is a support type unit. What his passive does is he gives all allies attack and defense 7,000. So not the greatest, but also not the worst either. And then he gives an additional 2,000 defense per giant category ally on the team. Because we have three, that's an additional 6,000 defense that he is going to be giving. That's a maximum buff that he can give. So the extra 6,000. So Shugesh will be giving all allies attack 7,000 and defense 13,000 throughout the majority of the fight. So, you know, I am curious enough to see, like, you know, some sort of unit like Turles, right? Or, you know, Great Ape Turles, a unit that's not necessarily a big defender, like how much damage they would take from, like, in Super Saiyan 3 Bardock, you know, once we get towards the later portions of the fight with Shugesh's passive active. See, like, you know, does it actually really make that big of a difference or not? Okay, so, see, we're not really going to get a good chance to see here, because Turles is, you know, he has the type advantage over this Super Saiyan 2 Bardock right here. Funny enough, here he is. That's that Bardock unit I was talking about. The originally, this Bardock dropped along with the AGL Super Saiyan Super Saiyan 2 Goku. And Shugesh, not this exact Shugesh, because this is the SSR, you know, Great Ape Shugesh. I was talking more, okay, 400k, that's not bad. That's not bad. That's not bad for 1% in the dupe system. Only 9,000 damage, too. Again, that's pretty good. That's really actually very solid. I'm a little impressed with Shugesh. I feel as though, again, he's a unit that actually could bring value to the team. Like, he's going to give a nice little, oh, we got a double transformation. Okay. He could give a nice little, you know, attack and defensive buff to the team. We're going through the event pretty slow right now. So we actually could see Evolution Blue Vegeta stack up his passive a little bit. You know, because there's still two phases of this fight after this. Ooh, okay, I'm a little excited now. It's very rare that Evolution Blue Vegeta gets, you know, very many attacks. So he doesn't usually have time to build up that additional crit chance he can get. In case you guys are unfamiliar, Evolution Blue Vegeta, every time he attacks, gets a 10% chance to crit from his passive. So what happens is, after he attacks seven times, he has a 70% crit chance from his passive, which is very nice. Okay, so I'm going to let Shugesh fall off the rotation right here. And this is going to be a really good test, because remember, Turles only gives an attack buff. He does not give a defensive buff. So Shugesh, you know, if this Great Ape Turles is able to take double digits just like that, I gotta imagine a good deal of that is from Shugesh's, you know, passive defensive buff. I really would like to see Bardock's super attack. Okay, perfect. Let's see how much damage this will do. If it does under 100k, we're living. Okay, yeah. It did well, when I said living, I mean, like, you know, that's a good thing. But it did 17 damage under 100k. There it is. Shugesh is the GOAT. Confirmed. Only 13k from Bardock. I'm going to tell y'all right now, I am strongly at this moment considering rainbowing Shugesh. I actually already did go ahead and pull the trigger and rainbow Great Ape Tora. I'm going to do a video on him in the upcoming days as well. I do feel as though that Great Ape Tora, it was worth rainbowing him. This Shugesh as well, I got some spots for him on some of my teams. Pretty good. Also, by the way, that's what? Four attacks by Vegeta? Five attacks by Vegeta? So at this point, that Evolution Blue Vegeta right there is going to be critting nonstop, because he's attacked five times. So he already has, I believe my Evolution Blue Vegeta has 15 crit. So that's a 30% chance to crit from the Hidden Potential system. And now he'll also have a 50% chance to crit from his passive. That's one reason Evolution Blue Vegeta is so, so strong and such a powerful unit. All right, so now we'll let this Evolution Blue Vegeta get some shots in as well. The Pure Saiyan team is just so much fun. Evolution Blue Vegeta as a unit, again, is also just so much fun to use. That's one reason I really love this Pure Saiyan team, is Evolution Blue Vegeta letting him run wild, and how frequently his transformations do occur. Like, transformation units, I think, add a lot to the game. Because unlike Great Apes, where, you know, Great Apes are transformed and we go, ugh. You know, units like Evolution Blue Vegeta or UI Goku transform, and we're like, yes! Yes! So that's why I'm glad that they are still adding a lot of those units. And that's why the transforming Goku and transforming Frieza are so much fun. Is because they're adding more of, like, that sort of feeling to when we're going through Dokkan events. Just the exhilaration when they transform is just really cool. Okay, so Evolution Blue Vegeta. I gotta imagine every attack this rotation is gonna be a crit. Oh, we're gonna get a Dokkan attack. Wow, we went through the event so slow we're getting a Dokkan attack. That goes to we'll go ahead and get this. Why not? Why not? Why not? We'll blow Super Saiyan 3 Bardock away with a very fun Evolution Blue Vegeta Dokkan attack. By the way, global players, I do believe Evolution Blue Vegeta will be the next Dokkan Fest that will be coming to Global Dokkan. Probably the very start of October, or like the very end of September, is when I do think he will be arriving. Presumably with the LR Frieza campaign, Jiren, and Dokkan Battlefield. I think all those things will arrive on Global at the same time when they all finally do come. So there we go. I'm actually pretty pleased with what I saw from rotations where Shugesh was around. On the rotations he was there, we took virtually no damage whatsoever, which is very nice. You know, even the super attack, you know, Great Ape Turles, who has no defensive buff whatsoever from his passive or anything, was able to mitigate damage quite nicely. You know, I was actually, again, very impressed. So this Shugesh unit, I might consider rainbowing him. We'll see. I have rainbowed most of the major units in my box, though, so he definitely could be getting rainbowed soon. So this is Greedy Fighting Posture Shugesh Giant Ape. That's a very weird name, by the way. His leader skill is Int Type Ki 2, HP Attack and Defense 70%. So I think his leader skill could be useful in Dokkan Battlefield as a sub-leader skill. His super attack is the Massive Catapult, which does supreme damage and greatly lowers defense. His passive skill, Tough Physical Strength, is all allies, attack and defense 7,000. Plus he gives an additional defensive buff of 2,000 per giant category ally on the team, up to a 6,000 buff. So basically, if you have two other giant category units, because Shugesh himself always counts as one, then you'll be able to get the 6,000 buff. So if you have no other giant category units on the team, Shugesh will be giving all allies attack 7,000 and defense 9,000. Because again, he himself does count as one towards his passive. And then he also has a chance to turn into the giant ape up to 2 times. Links are Team Bardock, Saiyan Pride, Tough as Nails, the Saiyan Lineage, Transform, Saiyan Roar, and Shattering Limit. He probably rainbow level with Saiyan Roar, Saiyan Pride, and those are his attack links. Only with Saiyan Roar and Saiyan Pride. I don't know if that'll be enough for him to get a 1 million attack stat, but like, if Turles is on the rotation and maybe he's linked up with Great Ape Tora as well, it might be close, and he's rainbowed, he could probably get close to a 1 million attack stat. That'd be interesting. 12k multiplier is 140%, which I guess is fine for a unit like this. And then he does have 3 categories. Two of them are quite bad, though. He's on the low-class Saiyan category, which, again, not very great. And he's also on the Giant category. And then, of course, he's on one of my favorites in the game, the pure Saiyan category, which just has so many options, so many good units. And even Shugesh, I think, is a pretty solid option on that team. So there we go, guys. There is Great Ape Shugesh. Now I have done awakenings and videos for all of the Great Ape Awakenings that just came with the newest update. So shout outs to that. Thank y'all for watching. Shout outs to y'all for the support, and I will catch y'all next time.